So in my past class, up to what we have done, we had left the equation somewhere else. So our after putting all the things in the mirror equation, what I am having what? Minus u plus r. This I had minus u plus r. In the denominator part, I am having minus r plus minus r plus v, that I am having. Okay, no confusion. That is equal to what I am having, minus of f, minus f by, that is a focal length, minus f by minus b plus f, minus b plus f. The problem is that here I am having r, here I am having r. R is what? Total radius of curvature, which is twice of focal length. So what I need to do here, I need to put twice of focal length, means 2f. In place of r, I will put 2f. So minus u plus 2f by minus 2f plus v, that is equal to minus f minus v plus f. Done. Now take, cancel out all the minus signs. So I will have u minus twice f 2f minus v. Done. Here I will have f by v minus f. Done. Now I will do what? I will do the cross multiplication. That is u minus twice f into v minus f. And here f into 2f minus v. Done. So if I do the multiplication right now, I will have uv, okay, uv minus uf minus 2fb minus 2fb. Done. 2fb and plus 2f square. Similarly here I will get twice f square minus fb. So this twice f square is cancelled out. So rest of the part, uv minus uf minus 2fb. Here I am having another minus fb. If it is coming to this side, it will be plus fv, that equal to 0. So let's do, that is uv minus uf minus fv. Now do one thing, divide all the side with uvf. If I divide all the side with uvf, what I will have? Uv by uvf minus uf by uvf minus fb by uvf, that is equal to 0. That is equal to 0. So if I do here, rest of the part here, what I will have? That is 1 by f minus 1 by v minus 1 by u, that is equal to 0. Take this to this side, that is 1 by f equal to 1 by v plus 1 by u. This was the pending part. Proof is very important. 3 marks with the diagram, you need to give the proof. Proof in PDF also I had given, so go for that. Okay, so this is the pending part for mirror equation. Others, one data you haven't given me, that is how much left in that electromagnetic scattering part. Means light is a form of electromagnetic radiation. So if it is a electromagnetic radiation, then it should have a spectrum band. So that partner you haven't given me. And eye defect done, myopia, hypermetropia, this part done or not, that I don't know, that is not given. Okay, so do one thing, these things now you know already, but still I am giving you glimpses because these are important for exam, and this part is also important for your madhyamik also. Here I am giving you glimpses, read once. If you can't, you ask me on the online classes, I will make it clear there. Acha, I am doing from this part, from elements of physical science. Okay, in my book it is page number 51. In your book, what is the page number? I don't know. So page number 51, I am doing the things what I am doing, that is structure from that defects in human eye. Defects in human eye, that part, and spectrum part. Okay, what you need to read, just listen. See, in our eye is a form of biological lens. Okay, it forms of a convex lens. Our eye is just like a convex lens, and that convex lens is circumference that surrounded by ciliary muscle. That convex lens, I'm showing you, that convex lens is surrounded by various ciliary muscle. Okay, various ciliary muscle means what are those? Suppose this is a convex lens, this is a convex lens, and it is here muscles, ciliary muscles, here also ciliary muscles are there. So when I want to see in the farther view, is something which present is very far from me, so I will squeeze my eye like that. Means I am making thick the lens, I am making thick my lens. Why I am making thick my lens? Because if lens has been thickened, means its focal length will be increased, and if focal length is increased, has been increased, then what you are doing, focal length is increased, then you can see a larger distance. Similarly, when something very front of us, I am doing just relaxing my muscle like that, relaxing my muscle, ciliary muscle. Why? Because I am doing thickening, I am reducing the thickness of the biological lens. So if I reducing thickness of the biological lens, means I am reducing actually the focal length of the lens. So if I reduce focal length of the lens, I can see very nearer vision, I can have very nearer vision. See, so that is done by our ciliary muscle. But the problem is that if your ciliary muscle loosen its property or does not work properly, so that time two kind of eye defects came. One is myopia, another is hypermetropia. One is myopia, another is hypermetropia, all given in the book. I will give a note there also, you will get these things, and I will mark. See, for right now it's not possible for me to write everything because time is very short. So in book, how much part is needed, I will mark it there, okay, by pencil, so you need read that. So myopia is what? Myopia is that is when you can't see very longer distance. Means you are having a short-sightedness vision. Means short distance you can see, but longer distance you can't see. Means you are having minus power in your lens. Clear? Myopia means minus power. Hypermetropia means plus power you are having. Means hypermetropia means you are having a long sightedness. Means long distance you can see, but nearer distance you can't see. So how we will correct those things? Myopia will be corrected by concave lens, and hypermetropia will be corrected by convex lens. Remember that myopia will be corrected by concave lens, and hypermetropia will be corrected by convex lens. Why? What is the problem in case of myopia? Myopic patient, just like me, because I am having a huge power in my glasses, that is minus 6.5 something. So those are having myopia problem. Their ciliary muscle completely loosen its property. Means if I wish, I can't ever squeeze my muscle. I can relax it, but I can't squeeze it. Clear? That squeezeness property gone, permanently gone from me. So what? So if the you can't squeeze the lens, means you can't thick, you can't make thick the lens. So what is the problem for myopic patient? See the diagram. For myopic patient, what is happening? That the image is forming somewhere beyond retina. Okay, somewhere beyond retina. So image is, if image is formed image is formed beyond retina, means what? Suppose your retina is here, okay, you should get your image here, but instead of that, just in front of retina, here your image is here. So you will see what? The light is always following straight line path. So actually image is forming here, but your retina is here. Retina will sense what? Image. But it is not getting the image. What it is getting? The light coming parallel from here. Means actually we are getting a blurry image of a thing which is present very long side from me. Clear? So what they are doing in front of my convex lens, they are giving a as per my requirement, they are giving a concave lens, and for that reason that concave lens make all the things visible in on the retina. Clear? That is a myopic patient. Hypermetropia is doing what? They are forming the image back of the retina, means at that time they can get the clear vision. So they are getting the convex lens. So one convex lens already they are having, another convex lens they are adding. So it will make the image forms in just on the retina. So myopic patient means short sightedness minus power. Hypermetropia means long sightedness plus power. What are those? I had given in the note. You just go through that. Another things you need to write, need to learn, that is what is dispersion, what is dispersion, what is scattering of light, and what is electromagnetic spectra. Okay, so scattering and that electromagnetic spectra, na, like that you could not be understood. Okay, it's not possible for me to make video on that. I am giving you a glimpse of that on my. I am having another online class with you probably. So there I will explain this myopia, hypermetropia, as well as that remaining part of the scattering part. Very few part remaining, only one or two page. So that you will read. So what is the important for exam? If I say that is all the numerical problems we have done, that is important. Acha, you have done. Acha, equation means mirror equation, and that radius of curvature and focal length equation, these two equation is important, as well as that prism equation is important. In case of thermal phenomena, that is alpha beta gamma equations are important. Okay, alpha beta gamma equations are important. Again, that thermal conductivity equations are important. So these equation, how they are established, and that why this is proportional, why that is inversely proportional. When you are drawing mirror, then give sign properly. When you are giving us lens, that sign convention properly and structure of lens properly. Okay, now you can tell me, ask me, ma'am, if there are too many parts remaining. No, only today what is your work, you will read mirror equation from my note. Any confusion, ask me on the online class. Second thing, read about myopia, hypermetropia from my notes. Anything can't understood, ask me. Done. These two work I am giving. Only dispersion, scattering of light, part remaining, that I will explain in my online class. And whatever question you are having regarding light chapter for exam, jot down all things and ask me during the online class. Okay, so that's the thing. So again I am telling, today we have done what? Mirror equation, that myopia, hypermetropia thing. Acha, now the thing is that we have done thermal phenomena that day on my online classes. Okay, so that time few of them asked me about the what diagram we are needed. In case of thermal phenomena, only that diagram, that is superficial expansion, linear expansion, volume expansion, only that diagram you need to memorize. Acha, for case of light diagram in exam, always use pencil, because if by pen you will do, you will get it wrong, then you will want the correction, you can't do. And when you are giving light diagram, remember from which direction to which direction ray is coming, means arrow, is very much important. Those who will not give direction sign in their light equation, they will get a big zero. Direction sign is very much important for light equation and light and that things you have done now, Priyanka ma'am, or which ma'am, Gorima ma'am, who has done that is, suppose this is your convex lens, this is focus, this is twice of focus. So if the object placed here, what will be the image? If object placed here, what will be the image? Or if object placed here, what will be image? That kind of things you have to learn. Okay, so that's all for this class. And again I am telling, if you are giving answer of light, give direction sign, because direction sign is very important for case of light. Clear? So that's all for today class. Read properly. If any question is there, ask me in the online class. Thank you.